The art of creating modern stained glass for the interior and exterior decor of your home. A Ukrainian master who was inspired by the works of Louis Comfort Tiffany. How separate pieces of glass are collected in the overall picture. UATV visited a stained glass master whose life was totally transformed by art. Ancient civilizations possessed such technologies that we have never dreamed of today. This popular scientific statement is often found in combination with stories about visits of aliens to the planet Earth and other historical fiction. But is it possible to discard this theory completely? For 60 years, the Lycurgus cup has become preserved in a British museum. It is a beautiful glass vessel, the creation of which scientists date back to the 4th century AD. It was made in accordance to the Roman nanotechnology. Indeed, the Lycurgus cup changes color depending on the angle of the light, from green to red. Scientists have concluded that particles of gold and silver of about 70 nanometers in size react to this change. They are dissolved in the glass in a certain ratio. Modern experiments have reproduced a similar effect, but no one can answer the question with certainty. Did the ancient masters know what they were doing, or did they simply get lucky? The second theory is very likely because most of the Roman silver contained small admixtures of gold, apparently due to mudding in the workshops. Experimenting with the glass, someone could make a nanotechnological breakthrough, not knowing what was really behind this phenomenon. At the end of the 19th century, one American designer conducted such experiments quite consciously and made a revolution in the art of stained glass. Our workshop has already been producing classic stained glass windows for 12 years now by applying the technique of Louis Comfort Tiffany. This work is very exciting. Eduard Yusenko and his wife Alla work with hundreds of fragments of colored glass of various shades and textures. There's always a lot of work to be done, for example, light panels, lamps or windows upon custom order. Production of stained glass is quite a specific business. At the moment, very few people know all the features of this art and understand exactly what a Tiffany stained glass window is. So why an American designer from a famous family of jewelers was considered a revolutionary in stained glass? How difficult is it to learn modern methods of working with colored glass and to find lovers of your work? Later in the program, how both Eduard and Alla Usenko create Ukrainian stained glass windows. Another preserved Roman artifact of surprisingly skillful work is also kept in a British museum. It is the so-called Portland vase. It was created between 5 and 25 AD. It is a two-layered artistic glass following the example of a cameo made of precious stones. When the masters in the 19th century tried to reproduce this product, the work was so time-consuming that it took about 3 years to create a copy. Once a vandal broke a Portland vase, but it was restored piece by piece. Interest to this artifact spurred the French master and one of the founders of the Art Nouveau style, Emile Gallet, to work with cameo glass. A young man from a very rich American family of jewelers once visited the production facility and, inspired by what he saw, returned to the US to start up his own business for the production of a stained glass window. It was a Louis Comfort Tiffany. When he was making his stained glass windows, many fragments after manufacturing were left and there was a lot of glass waste. The glass was unbelievably beautiful, and he was very disconcerted by the fact that such beautiful glass would go to waste. The fact is that the well-known medieval stained glass windows in temples are made using a rough and thick spike. The main feature of monumental art with images in an entire wall is in the first place its strength, not the refinement of the details. On the other hand, colored glass has always been so expensive that it never occurred to anyone to make household items using mini stained glass windows. No one except Tiffany. He took a small copper sheet. spread it with wax, put it on a plank, cut it into stripes, and wrapped those small details of the future stained glass window with these strips, and then soldered them together. This was exactly how the first stained glass windows of Tiffany appeared. Stained glass windows were not in vogue, but using the Tiffany technique became a popular way to decorate the interior of one's home. Эдуард Юсенко was engaged in trade and was convinced that his main hobby would become photography. My wife and I visited the profile exhibition. In the pavilion next to us, there was a building exhibition. We went there for a walk and I saw an exhibition of a stained glass workshop. I practically froze in front of that exhibit stand. When my wife pinched me to pull me out of my trance, I told her that she would continue taking care of the business and that I would focus on stained glass work. She could hardly believe my words. 12 years later, they both work with the stained glass windows in the family workshop. Эдуард Юсенко, especially for UATV, shares his experience in making Tiffany stained glass from scratch and some of his secrets in this meticulous and highly detailed craft. In Ukraine, there are several old schools of work with glass, including colored glass. One of them is located in Lviv region. Эдуард Юсенко left everything and went to this school. For 2 weeks he studied the basics of the craft presented by an experienced master and made his first small stained glass window there. Not quite imagining all the difficulties, the master returned home and started his new work. The problem was not only connected with technology, but also with the search for connoisseurs of stained glass art. I arrived, bought equipment, bought glass, rented the place, began to master it and offer my work to designers and construction companies. This wasn't all that interesting to anyone. But a year and 7 days later, the first client came to my workshop. You can only imagine the state of mind of an artist who for this long period of time tried to break through this wall with his forehead. Эдуард Юсенко made the first window upon custom order. Since then, the method of his work hasn't changed, with the exception of professional nuances that were due to his own mistakes. Today, Эдуард puts on his priority list preparations for the background of a stained glass window. Making a sketch is a very important stage. The sketch should be clear to the client. As a rule, these people do not quite understand the material and therefore do not fully see the future picture. They, as a rule, trust me at this stage. To paint, the future stained glass is not the same as painting an ordinary picture. Paints on the canvas will stay anyway, but the glass in the frame is not a fact. It is the same as laying a brick wall, but not from rectangular blocks, rather those from open work and with different sizes. One serious mistake with the calculation of the voltage and everything will collapse. There's a whole set of application rules for the construction of a stained glass image. For example, it should not have long single lines. Imagine a long stalk that is thin and long. The longer it will be, the greater the chance that it will break in a large structure right here in this place. If we link this stalk in some place with another stalk or by some other rather graceful line, then we will remove the tension in this major detail. Often Эдуард makes adjustments at the sketch stage. Redoing stained glass from scratch is very expensive. The master buys the best color and texture glass from American manufacturers who are fanatics of Louis Tiffany. To start cutting, you need to make two models of full-size stained glass. All fragments on them are numbered with marks with the brand and color of the glass. Then we use one of the copies, which will serve as templates that will be cut with special scissors. The word special is not just what I said, because there are stained glass scissors that cut the layout, cutting a small stripe width of 0.8 mm. It is necessary so that when making a real stained glass window, there remains a gap for metal adhesions. In the meantime, Эдуард and his wife lay out the cut templates on the glass and decide what kind of detail it will have, namely its color and texture. Эдуард says that even with professional equipment, only an experienced master can achieve the desired shape and not spoil the sheet. Many pieces of glass are still uneven or larger than necessary. Эдуард processes the edges using a special piece of machinery and gives it to Алла for winding with copper tape. Since childhood, she was very fond of needlework and copes with this work better than her husband does.
это очень такая.
This is a very delicate job. With female fingers, it works best.
Мальчиками это лучше всего получается. Да.
Of course, I can do all the processes. You know, this is already a family business.
Безусловно. Ну, вот такое разделение нам удобно. И вот здесь в этом моменте наступает такой очень интересный этап. Это уже как family business. Когда
when there are a lot of details on the table, we wrap them up, turn on some film, steep two cups of tea, and have a great time while working.
Дальше время, работая.
After that, the time comes to undertake the most critical final procedure, soldering the parts. Edward uses a mixture of lead and tin in a ratio of 69:31. This is the same as slinking by a minefield. If the glass overheats from the flame, it can burst. So it should be removed and replaced. That is the restoration of a new stained glass window. It is difficult to solder parts on an uneven surface. Stray glass fragments need to be heated and bent in a furnace so that they assume a rounded shape. However, Edward does not always follow this rule. He acquired the original sketch of Louis Tiffany, but he introduced to this procedure a very interesting author's solution.
В его конструкции присутствуют.
In its design, there are bamboo leaves. They are very long and sharp. And when these leaves are laid on the form, the parts stick out. First, I wanted to bend these leaves in the oven in order to follow the line of the ceiling. But later, I came up to the conclusion that the protruding parts would be more appropriate here. If you look closely, you can see that the bamboo leaves break out of the shape of the lampshade, as if they were alive. Dark patina, applied with a special solution, traces flawless lines. Later, Эдуард Усенко used protruding parts to create this composition with irises. For the hostess of this house, Edward made many stained glass windows for various interior elements and even the exterior. The production of each of these stained glass windows lasts for 2 to 3 months.
Изюмищем просто таким огромным.
The stained glass window in each interior can be a real highlight.
Это ваш витраж будет душой.
As one client told me, Edward, your stained glass window will be the soul of my house. We made this stained glass window from very expensive glass with a very difficult plot.
Без ложной скромности она заплакала.
In recent years, Эдуард Усенко gained experience in the restoration of historic stained glass windows in Europe and became a teacher. Not only those who want to master this art as a new profession come to his workshop, but also ordinary people in search of new aesthetic sensations. An opera singer and an engineer of a passenger liner have visited this workshop. Эдуард and Алла Усенко are happy to share their knowledge with students and dream that people would stop seeing only monumental art in stained glass windows.
То это витражи.
These are stained glass windows, which are installed not only in a church and in some mansions, but can also be aesthetic in private apartments. It can be both a ceiling and windows, it can be light panels, or it can be not only bright spots, which in modern interiors do not fit in anyway. It could be something elegant with simple lines and a very simple color solution. That is, in fact, the stained glass can be installed in almost any interior. This only depends on one's artistic taste and desire that would be the most suitable for your own home.